In this short video lesson, I will tell you how to make leaves in Somebana technique. This Somebana technique is completely different from French flower making technique. These leaves have a lining. Here I use a natural silk satin for leaves. I prefer a medium thickness and shiny silk for the leaves. However, you can use another types of natural silk. I have already stiffened my material using polyvinyl alcohol stiffener. You can buy this universal stiffener in my online shop. You know that you have to cut the material on the bias. I trace two leaves and cut them. When we cut the petals, we cut inside of a pencil line. For leaves, I cut around the leaf and don't cut the details. My students like, but for patterns I use all X-ray film. It's handy because they can last much longer than paper patterns. You see, I left some pencil lines and cut them later. I prepared the piece of thin natural silk for the lining. The hubba tie will be ideal for lining. Now I will show you how to paint the leaves. I don't know what country you live and what dyes are available for you. You can use professional Japanese dyes. I use landscape powder dyes. They are very concentrated, so reasonably economical dyes. The disadvantage is that if you make a liquid dye from the powder, you can't keep it for a long time. Brushes. Of course, you can buy the expensive Japanese professional brushes. However, the usual painting brushes will work very well. Take into account that they have to be flat and soft. Whenever paint dry flower pots, we have to wet them first. Green dye. I don't like ready-to-use green dye. It is very bright and unusual unnatural color. I prefer to mix blue and yellow dyes for leaves myself in different proportions. You can add some drops of other dyes for a variation. My rose will be pink, so I use the basic color of our petals for shading the leaves. Let's start! I use the tweezers to hold the parts of the flower to dip them into the water. I forgot to say, but I paint the parts of the flower, putting them on a piece of clean white paper. Lot of people use newspapers. Newspapers absorb the moisture very well. Don't forget that it has to be at least 2 weeks old newspaper. I don't like to work on newspaper, because I don't see very well what I am doing. Some flower makers are fans of painting on glass. It depends on you, you can try everything and choose what you like better. I wet my leaf by dipping it into the water and taking it out straight away. Put it on the paper and paint the leaf with green dye. I add a little bit of a pink on the edges of the leaf using our brush, all the time blending the colors and avoiding sharp boundaries between the colors. Turn it over and repeat the same way on the other side. When I have finished, I put the leaf on the other piece of paper to dry. I turn the leaf over time to time. I repeat the same for the other leaf. When you prepare dyes for flower, please note that the color will be less bright when the silk is dry. Now I paint the piece of silk for lining. This is very thin material, so I painted only one side. I paint the wire as well. This is very good quality Japanese wire. I bought it online, it has cotton cover and could be painted. Look at the leaves of this flower. I even didn't use the green dye for them at all. I blended pink, gray and blue colors. I love this flower myself. I think it's very stylish. My parts for leaves now are dry. It's better if you can iron them. I cut the pieces of wire that I need for the leaves. We don't glue the central vein of the leaf like this. There are only nice banded lines in Somebana technique. I use Japanese PVA glue. For silk and fabric flowers, we use only wood PVA glue. I bought this glue online. If you can't buy Japanese glue, use the PVA glue from hardware shops, not from office or craft shops. We need a thick glue. I spread a little bit glue on a piece of plastic. I use a toothbrush for it and try to spread the glue in one direction. Put my leaves back sides on the glue surface. Press it everywhere so all the back side of leaf will be covered by glue. Put the vein. And glue the leaf and the lining together. Press again carefully. I even trace the vein with nails. Should be careful that there aren't the air bubbles. Put a wet cloth nearby to clean your fingers from glue so you don't leave glue marks on the leaf. Repeat the same for our leaf. When my leaves get completely dry, I will cut them properly, cutting off all the pencil lines. For shaping the leaves, Somebana technique, I use a single knife and a Japanese middle knife. These tools are including in my set of tools that I sell online. They are some of the most important flower making tools. They are extremely useful. To work with flower making tools, we need a sponge, soft and hard or hard proof hard. You have to cover them with clean cotton fabric, better white. You can buy these sponges online, but it's very easy to make them yourself. For example, to my hard sponge, I cut up a neat mat bought in usual hardware shop. Not everybody knows, but we never work with completely dry pieces of our future flower. I take a towel, could be small, like a washer, wet in well and squeeze it strongly. I put my leaves in a folded washer, not for a long time. I want the leaves to be a little bit damp. It helps us to make nice round curves in our leaves, not sharp folds. First, we will work with a single knife. I put the damp leaf front sides up on the half hard sponge. Make the line along the stalk. Don't push too hard. It's better to be slow and careful than quick and strong. Make these lines next. Remember, this isn't a Christmas tree. Your lines have to be curved. I turn our leaf over and start shaping it with Japanese iron. Usually I use narrow or middle iron for this. Don't forget, only smooth curved lines. Never move your Japanese iron in a straight line. Exception will be petals of chrysanthemums. Try to move it in a smooth line. Make the lines, bending the edge of the leaf with your fingers or the other hand. It's easy to do when the material is hot. Don't worry about the lines from a single knife. We will make the line along the stalk from the other side. Turn the leaf over again and repeat the same for the left side of the leaf. I received very nice interesting leaf. I shape our leaf the same way. As you see, it isn't very simple to make nice leaves, but the result is worth it. Somebana technique is full of secrets. I tell more about them in my online class, a full guide to using flower making tools. You can buy it in my online shop. Happy creating!